Next is Marc Stevens.
Excuse my camera, my main one is broken. I think the members of the council and mayor, you know what my issue probably is. I've been confronting or requesting evidence that your constitution, the say constitution laws and the laws that you pass apply to me just because I'm physically in Scottsdale, and I've not been able to get any kind of evidence. Your city attorney, his office or his secretary said he was not going to speak to me. But I do want to give a shout out to your to Mr. Fritz Behring, who had the decency and the professionalism to speak with me and actually be honest enough that if he couldn't produce the evidence, he said, "I don't know." He didn't just get loud with me. He didn't throw me out of the office, and he wasn't like your police. He didn't threaten to put me in jail because I asked a question that he felt was uncomfortable. So again, I put the question to you, since the generalization is that you believe that the constitutional laws of the state of Arizona apply to me, and also your local rules and regulations apply to me, for no other reason than I'm physically in Scottsdale. And I know you all agree with that generalization, because your police enforce it at the barrel of a gun every day. My question is, what evidence do you have to prove that that's actually true?
Mr. Stevens, are you done then?
I'm asking a question. I'd like a response.
As I explained at the beginning, this is a public comment period of time. It is not a point of an agenda item where there's any discussion or even a response. So thank you very much.
Well, then I'll take the remainder of the time.
Okay.
The reason why I'm doing this is because when you go to your courts, there is collusion between your prosecutors and your judges. And I know you may not have much oversight over your judges, but you absolutely have oversight over your prosecutors and your police officers. We're getting tired of your judges colluding with your prosecutors and your police officers to give the cops and your prosecutors a free pass on the issue of jurisdiction. And now when we go in there, we have these corporate psychopaths called judges screaming from their wooden throne to have us thrown in jail because we dared ask a question that the prosecution has to prove beyond a reasonable doubt anyway. So what I'm going to be putting forth is, and at least Fritz was open to this, to some kind of public investigation, some kind of public hearing, where we can pull your judges and prosecutors out of their hallowed halls, where they don't have the opportunity to start yelling and screaming and threatening me with contempt, just because I'm asking a question for evidence the prosecution is supposed to have anyway. And I'm going to continue asking you, every one of you in your offices, and I expect a response. If you have evidence, please present it. If you don't, please be honest like Fritz and say, "I don't know." Because if you don't have the evidence, and I don't believe that you do, then the collusion between your judges and your prosecutors and your police officers, it makes you look like nothing more than a criminal organization. If you claim that you have some kind of legal authority, you have no actual evidence to prove it. All you have are the guns of these police officers. So I'd expect in the next few weeks, or the next few days, that you would be professional enough to present me with the evidence or be honest and say, like Fritz did, "I don't know."
Thank you, Mr. Stevens.